Hello children, welcome to biology class. Today we are going to discuss about the pistil, megasporangium, that is the ovule, and the embryo. Okay, so the development and formation of female gametophyte. Children, we know that the gynecium represent the female reproductive part of the flower. So this is a structure of carpel or pistil. It consists of three parts. Which are the three parts, children? The stigma and long and elongated style, and the ovary. Inside the ovary there are ovules, isn't it? So the gynecium may consist of single pistil or may have multiple pistil. See, this is a monocarpillary flower. That means a single pistil is there. These two diagram B and diagram C are examples for multicarpillary flowers. Multicarpillary means a flower which is having more than one pistil. But you just observe, again differences are there. This P, it's a papaver plant's flower. This is a multicarpillary syncarpus. Whereas this one, this one is multicarpillary apocarpus. So what is the difference between syncarpus and apocarpus flower? We have discussed in class 11, isn't it? So syncarpus means pistils are fused. The multiple pistils are fused together in syncarpus flowers. Whereas in apocarpus flowers, the pistils are free. Okay, so that's the difference between syncarpus and apocarpus flowers. Now about the parts of pistil, we know that pistil is having three parts: the stigma, style, and ovary. The stigma, this is stigma. What is importance? Stigma serves as landing platform for pollen grains, isn't it? Pollen grains will fall on here and stick here, and it is followed by long and slender style. Okay, and this basal part, this basal bulged part is ovary. Inside the ovary, there is ovarian cavity or locule. Then the placenta is located inside the ovarian cavity. In class plus one, we had discussed about placentation. Do you remember it? Then arising from the placenta are megasporangia, commonly called ovules. See children, these are ovules. So we are going to discuss about the megasporangium or ovule. Children, the ovule is a small structure attached to the placenta by means of a stalk called funicle. Okay, see children, this is funicle. These are megasporangia or ovule. This is placenta. So by means of a small stalk funicle, it is attached. So funicle, it is attached to. See, this is funicle. Funicle, it is attached to the ovary. Okay, and next part we have to discuss is hilum. The body of the ovule fuses with funicle in the region called hilum. Okay, then each ovule has one or two protective envelope, which is known as integuments, covering outer integument and inner integument. Okay, the integuments encircle the nucellus. This is nucellus, not nucleus, nucellus. N-U-C-E-L-L-U-S, mass of cells are known as nucellus. This nucellus except at the place of nucellus except at the place of opening, which is known as micropyle. Okay, micropyle, and opposite to micropyle there is chalaza, representing the basal part of the ovule. Okay, then enclosed within integument there is mass of cells called nucellus. Cells of nucellus have abundant and reserve food materials. Located in the nucellus is the embryo sac, female gametophyte. So an ovule generally has single embryo sac formed from a megaspore. So if the question is asked to write the parts of megasporangium, how you will start, children? The first one is funicle. What is funicle? The ovule is a small structure attached to placenta by means of a stalk. So the stalk is known as funicle. And the body of ovule fuses with the funicle at the region of hilum. Okay, so that is hilum. So hilum, you can see here. This is hilum. That in textbook page number 25, the diagram is there. Then the hilum represent the junction between this ovule and funicle. Okay, and two integuments are there: outer integument and inner integument. And internally there is a mass of cells that is known as nucellus. Okay, nucellus provide all the nourishment for the developing embryo sac inside the megasporangium. Is it clear? Now let's discuss the process of formation of megaspore. And this process of formation of megaspore from megaspore mother cell MMC is called megasporogenesis. Okay, children, you just observe this diagram. Ovules generally differentiate a single megaspore mother cell in the micropylar region of the nucellus. It's a large cell containing dense cytoplasm and a prominent nucleus. Okay? And this megaspore mother cell will undergo meiotic division. And they produce four megaspores. Out of four megaspores, only one will be functional. Three will degenerate. Okay? I will show you that diagram. Here, you just observe this. This megaspore mother cell is nucellus and it becomes megaspore mother cell. This megaspore mother cell undergo meiosis and produce four cells. Okay, four megaspore. Here, one division is taking place. Here, two divisions are taking place. Megaspore dyad form. Then megaspore tetrad. 1, 2, 3, 4. Megaspore tetrad form. Same as that of our microspore tetrad. But what's the difference? In microspore tetrad, that means for the formation of male gametophyte, from this microspore tetrad, four pollen grains will release. But it is not the condition in megasporogenesis. Here, out of four cells, only one become functional. Rest three will degenerate. Is it clear, children? And this cell, the single cell remained undergo continuous mitotic division. Okay, only for the formation of this tetrad, the cell division is meiosis. Then it is following mitosis. Observe this diagram. The nucleus of the functional megaspore divide mitotically to form two nuclei which move to the opposite pole. See, this is first mitotic division and it forms two nucleate embryo sac. Then two more sequential mitotic divisions result in the formation of four nucleate. This is four nucleate stage. This is four nucleate stage. Two nucleus will move to one pole, two to the other pole. Then later, eight nucleate stage. So in total, how many mitotic divisions happen here? The first mitotic division here, second mitotic division here, and the third mitotic division here. And finally, an eight nucleated stage of the embryo sac formed. Children, it is of interest to note that these mitotic divisions are strictly free nuclei. That means the nuclear divisions are not followed immediately by cell wall formation. That is very important, isn't it? Then what is next? After this eight nucleated stage, see, this is eight nucleated stage, isn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Eight nuclei are the. So after the eight nucleate stage, the cell walls are laid down or embryo sac. Lay down leading to the organization of typical female gametophyte. Okay. Then observe this distribution of cells now, children. Six of the eight nuclei are surrounded by cell walls and organized into cells. See, three here. 1, 2, 3. Three here and two here. This is distribution. Remaining two nuclei, that's in center. Remaining two nuclei in the center, it is known as polar nuclei, are situated below the egg apparatus in the large central cell. So there is a characteristic distribution of the cells within the embryo sac. Three cells are grouped together at the micropylar end and constitute the egg apparatus. See, this is micropylar end, na? So, the first two are synergy. The first cell, second cell. These two are synergids. Then, egg cell. These three cells will be at the micropylar end. Okay. Then, three at the chalazal end. It is known as antipodals. Okay, three at the chalazal end and two together at the central cell. It is known as polar nuclei. Okay, so the egg apparatus consists of two synergids and one egg cell. The synergids, you can see a special cellular thickening here, isn't it? It is known as filiform apparatus, which play an important role in guiding the pollen tube into synergids. Okay, while discussing the fertilization, let's discuss more about this. Now you just keep it in mind. What is the function of filiform apparatus? Filiform apparatus helps in guiding the pollen tube into the synergids. Okay, then three cells are located at the chalazal end. These are antipodals, and centrally large central cells. Okay, it is polar nuclei. So, the typical angiosperm embryo sac at maturity, it is a 8 nucleate 7 celled stage. Isn't it, children? 8 nucleated 7 cell stage. Why it is said so? How many nuclei are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Isn't it? So, 8 nucleate. And why it is 7 celled? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These two together, the central cell together, that's why it is 7 cell stage. So, if the question will ask for 1 mark, why it is 8 nucleated 7 cell stage, or question will ask like this, at maturity, how can you describe a matured embryo sac? So, you can write the answer attaining maturity. The embryo sac is 8 nucleate 7 celled stage. Clear, children? So, now let's discuss the megasporogenesis once again. So, this is nucellus. Here, nucellus megaspore mother cell. They will produce megaspore tetrad. Out of 3 out of 4, 1 will become functional megaspore and 3 will degenerate. And that functional megaspore undergo 3 nuclear mitotic division. The first division, second mitosis, third mitosis. And it form 8 nucleate stage. And out of this 8, 3 will move to a chalazal end, it become antipodals, 3 will move to micropylar end, 2 will become synergid, 1 will become egg cell, and the centrally located polar nuclei club together and it forms central cell. So, the matured embryo sac is 8 nucleate 7 celled stage. Clear, children? So, this is if the question is asked to draw the matured embryo sac on pistil, you have to draw the entire diagram. You have to draw the stigma, style and ovary inside the ovary, ovule with matured embryo sac. So, you have to draw the diagram like this. Then only you will get full mark. Okay. So, this is repeatedly asked question, children. Okay. So, that's about megasporogenesis. I hope the process is clear to you. You just read the textbook thoroughly and draw the diagrams. Diagrams in page number 2.8, you have to copy to your notebook and this diagram. Okay, matured embryo sac on pistil. That is a headline. And you have to copy this diagram to your notebook. Okay, children? So, study well.